Hey everyone, it's time for GeForce Fact or Fiction. Today we are discussing the question, does ray tracing matter for 60 class graphics cards like the GeForce RTX 4060 Ti or 4060? First, let's briefly go over what ray tracing is. It's essentially a method of graphics rendering that simulates the physical behavior of light. This enables much more realistic environments in games, including global illumination, reflections, shadows, and more. The latest GeForce RTX 40 series graphics cards are great at ray tracing, with dedicated RT cores for accelerating ray tracing and dedicated tensor cores for DLSS, which helps to further accelerate gaming performance. This leads us to our topic for today. Does ray tracing matter for 60 class cards like the GeForce RTX 4060 Ti or 4060? To illustrate this, let's take a look at some recent examples. Here we have Ratchet & Clank Rift Apart running at the high preset with all ray tracing options enabled on an RTX 4060 Ti. Ratchet & Clank makes heavy use of ray tracing for reflections and shadows. At 1080p resolution with DLSS and frame generation, we're getting over 80 frames per second, which is a great gaming experience. Now let's see what happens when we turn ray tracing off. You can see that by disabling ray tracing, we have lost a significant amount of environmental detail. The reflections, shadows, and other objects are not as refined or completely missing. Let's look at another example, this time from Hitman, World of Assassination. At maximum in-game settings with ray tracing, we are over 110 frames per second. Another great gaming experience. Again, let's turn ray tracing off to compare. As you can see, the reflection detail here takes a quality hit, whereas with ray tracing enabled, the reflections are more accurate and detailed. Let's take a look at one more example. This is the newly released Phantom Liberty expansion for Cyberpunk 2077, which has full support for DLSS 3.5. Here we are running at the ray tracing overdrive preset, which includes full path tracing and ray reconstruction for even more true-to-life visuals. The RTX 4060 Ti is able to get over 70 frames per second. With RTX off, the quality change is very apparent with missing or less realistic reflections, lower quality shadows, lighting, and more. An RTX 40 series card with path tracing and ray reconstruction in DLSS 3.5 is the best way to play Cyberpunk 2077. So what's the verdict? Does ray tracing matter for 60 class graphics cards? Based on our examples, it is clear this is a fact. Ray tracing when combined with the GeForce RTX 4060 Ti or 4060 can absolutely make for a great gaming experience. What topics would you like to see us cover on future GeForce Fact or Fiction episodes? Let us know in the comments below. Thanks again for watching, and we will see you next time.